Hello everyone, this is Manu, a design team member with Dress My Craft. Welcome to our YouTube channel. And before we start with the actual video, don't forget to hit the bell icon and subscribe to our channel to never miss an update from us. So today we will be making up these gorgeous loaded envelopes. The base for these envelopes is an acetate sheet, and I would be using the Pink Smoke paper collection for making this loaded envelope. So I would be using the Pink Smoke paper pack, the 12x12 collection kit, to make this loaded envelope. And I would also be using the acetate sheet available at Dress My Craft, which is of a very good quality. And we would be making the base. The base for the loaded envelope would be an acetate sheet. And I would also be sharing on how you can make an envelope using the multi-scoring board, the Dress My Craft scoreboard. And my envelope measures 5.5 inches by 5.5 inches. There is a triangle tool at the back of the scoring board, which will help you measure the dimensions of the envelope that you would be making. And you can make different types of envelopes using this scoring board. So the first is a normal envelope, and second is a box envelope, and the third is a gift box. So choose your measurements. I have chosen a 5.5 inch by 5.5 inch of an envelope. So I took my the base cardstock. I'm not using the cardstock over here, so I'm using the acetate sheet. So I've cut my acetate sheet to 8 1.5 quarters by 8 1.5 quarters, and then I have used the instructions that are measures that are given on the envelope maker to make the envelope. I'm using the Dress My Craft Teflon bolt holder over here to permanently crease the I am now choosing a pattern paper from the Dress My Craft Pink Smoke paper pack to fit to the size of the envelope. I will cut it in a way that it fits into the envelope and it can slide in and out of the envelope. We would now start embellishing our loaded envelope, and I would be using the Sunray stencil to create a little dimension to my project. Stenciling help in creating a lot of dimension, and it adds to creating textures, and it really helps while you are making a mixed media project. I am now using the Dress My Craft banner punch to create my other embellishments, and basically what I need is a lot of textures and of different kinds of embellishments we need before I start embellishing my project to make it look complete. Now here is another tip that I like using to create a lot of depth to my projects. I use cardstock behind my embellishments to make it look a little upper and to give it a lot of dimension. So this is one tip that you can use to add a lot of dimensions. Plus it also helps you to add on any little fillers or any little embellishments that you would like to add between the layers later on. Another thing that I like to do, especially during my free time, is that I do a lot of fussy cutting for all the motif sheets and keep it in a bag and I label it and I put in the, you always get a little tag for what that particular collection is for the motif sheets. So I keep it there and it really helps me when I'm making the projects and it relieves me from the last minute hassles of finding and fussy cutting. So you can do the same too. So I had these glass vials and they were from some place that I procured them from, and I, instead of throwing them away, I thought why not to use them for my projects and putting a little filler elements in there, the shaker elements or the sequins. This way I will be able to reuse them and also jazz up my projects. I'm now using the soft gloss gel by Art Basics. This is from Finnaware and it is a very nice medium and probably the best medium to stick your any art ingredient, for example the decor stones or any sequins or any little kind of embellishments that you would want your project to have. I am using the decor stones from Mudra to help my project in here. I am now using a little gesso to highlight certain areas and to tone down all the colors in my project. This really helps you to give a very nice finish and accentuate the beauty of your project. I hope you liked the project and enjoyed the video making process. Do subscribe to the channel and thank you for watching.